Good morning and welcome to Covenant Kids. We're so glad that you could join us this morning. You may have noticed that I have a couple of friends here who are going to be helping me out. We have Tyler. Hi, Tyler. And Kyle. Hi, Kyle. Thanks for joining us. And we also have Julia here. Let's just get to know our friends just a little bit. I've got just a quick question for you. All right, Kyle, let's start with you. If you won the lottery, what would you do? If you got like millions of dollars, if you won it all, what would you do? How about this? Let's choose a different one, okay? This one should be easy. What's your favorite dessert in the whole wide world, Kyle?
Cake.
Cake?
I've had
cake. Cake. Awesome. I love cake too. All right, Tyler. Mm-hmm. What do you want to be when you grow up?
I either want to be a video game designer or an architect.
Oh, fun. Either one of those and you're building something, right? Good for you.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Julia.
Yeah?
If you could have any superpower in the world, what would your superpower be?
I would want to fly in the sky.
Fly in the sky. That would be very cool, wouldn't it? Yeah. You know what? Thanks for joining me, you guys, and thanks for helping me out. I appreciate that. We are going to be celebrating today that Jesus is alive. We've been talking a lot about that in these last few weeks, right? Before we start talking about that, why don't we sing? Today we're going to sing Rescuer, Good News by Wren Collection. So let's tune in, and here is Wren Collection.
He's our rescuer, he's our rescuer. We are free from sin forevermore. Oh, how sweet the sound, oh, how grace abounds. We will praise the Lord, our rescuer.
There is good news for the captive, good news for the shame. There is good news for the world who walked away. There is good news for the doubter, the one religion failed. For the good Lord has come to seek and save.
He's our
there is redemption.
great singing, guys. Well done. You know, the good news just keeps getting better. We already know Jesus is alive. And number two, we know that Jesus loves us. Number three, he gave us a job to do. Does anybody remember what that job was?
To make disciples of all nations?
Oh, wow. You are correct. He said we need to make disciples of all nations. There was a fancy name for that. I'm just wondering, Kyle or Tyler, do either of you remember what that fancy name for that was called? It was called the Great
Commission.
Commission. Yeah, that was called the Great Commission. So that's right. He gave us a job to do. So now we are actually going to sing about how we can share Jesus' love and how we can show the message of Jesus' love to others. We're going to sing again, Walk Like Jesus. That was excellent singing, you guys. Thank you so much. Before we dive in again, I would just like for us to pray together, okay? Does anybody have any prayer requests that they would like for me to pray about right now? Oh, you know what?
I would like COVID-19 to get over with.
Pardon me?
I would like COVID-19 to be
done.
Out the door.
Yes.
Get out the door, COVID.
Right. Okay. Kyle, do you have any prayer requests right now? No? That's okay. Don't worry about it. Julia, do you have anything you'd like?
Yeah, Grandpa Jerry doesn't get it because he has a lot bad lungs.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So, guys, we are going to talk to God right now. So, we're going to fold our hands. We're going to close our eyes. And we are going to have a conversation with our Lord. Dear Jesus, the news about you isn't just good, it's great. Knowing that you died on the cross for our sins, came back to life, and continue to watch over us today is so wonderful. Help us always to be prepared to share your great news with others. Dear Lord, specifically, we would like to pray for COVID-19 to be done. We'd love to get back to our daily routine and see our friends and go to school. Please help this illness to go away so that we can go back to normal. Especially please be with Julia's Grandpa Jerry and help him to not get this illness, because there are some people who are more vulnerable than others. Please keep him safe and keep him healthy. We ask this all in your name. Amen. Okay, so today we are going to continue talking about the good. Looks like somebody is going to come on in here. What's that? Oh, hi, Tyler. Hey. Did you bring me something?
Yes.
What did you bring me?
A Diet Coke.
A Diet Coke. He knows this is my favorite drink. Thank you for bringing this to me. Hey, how have you been lately?
Sad.
You've been kind of sad? How come you're feeling sad?
Because I can't see my friends.
You need to come in a little bit closer. Because you can't see your friends?
Yeah.
I think a lot of us are sad because we can't see our friends. Hey? Okay. Well, thanks for bringing me my favorite drink. I'll talk to you later, okay?
Goodbye, bye. My favorite brother.
That delivery person looked kind of familiar to me. Maybe they look kind of familiar to you too. Do you remember what color t-shirt he was wearing?
Yeah, I do.
What color t-shirt was he wearing?
Orange.
Okay. Was that person tall or was he short? Let's see if Tyler remembers. Was that person tall or short?
Short.
He was short. Okay. Do you remember what color hair he had?
Blonde hair.
Does. He's got blonde hair. That's right.
Like mine.
What did he give me?
I know.
Do you remember what he came to deliver?
A Diet Coke.
That's right. He brought me a Diet Coke. Right? Thank you. And what did we talk about? Do you remember if we talked about anything specific? Kyle, do you remember what we talked about at all?
A great mission.
Pardon me? What did Tyler and I talk about when he was coming in here? What?
How he was feeling.
How he was feeling.
And thank you for giving me my favorite Diet Coke.
Do you remember how he was feeling?
And he named it Jerry.
Sad.
He was feeling sad. That's right. You know what? You guys actually remembered a lot of details about Tyler just coming in and giving me a drink, right? You guys would make really good witnesses.
What's that?
A witness is somebody who sees something and tells other people about it. You guys told me all about Tyler's visit here just now, my delivery man, right? That reminds me of today's story, actually. Today's story is when we talk about and learn about a day when the disciples witnessed something quite unusual. After they witnessed it, they were told to be Jesus' witnesses, right? So they actually witnessed Jesus going up into the clouds, his ascension, and then they were told to go and witness to the whole world, right? Today's story comes from Acts, the book of Acts from chapter 1. So after Jesus died on the cross, he visited his friends actually quite a bit. He ate dinner with them and he talked a lot about the kingdom of heaven. But after 40 days, it was time for him to go back home to his heavenly father. It was time for him to leave earth, right? Do you guys ever have it where if you get a babysitter, your mom might give the babysitter some special instructions like, okay, this is what you guys get to have for dinner. They can have this much TV. They can have this for a snack. Bedtime is this time, right? They probably get some special instructions, right?
Because Abby's our babysitter, and you always do that.
And I give her special instructions too. Yeah.
Like not a lot of electronics. Go play outside.
Yep. Okay. So the disciples also received special instructions from Jesus on that day. Right? Jesus invited them to the mountaintop in order to give them some special instructions, right? Okay, so right now we are going to tell everybody about the story of Jesus ascending, okay? So this is specifically why Tyler and Kyle and Julia are here to help me tell the story, okay? So are you guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, so I'm going to start getting my rhythm ready. And then you guys are going to be my echo. Do you remember? And you might need to wait a little bit for them. Okay? So I'm going to get my rhythm going. Okay? Going up the mountaintop.
Going up the mountaintop.
With the disciples.
With
the disciples.
I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid.
Are you?
Are you?
Going up the mountaintop.
Going up the mountaintop.
Gonna meet Jesus.
Gonna meet Jesus.
I can't wait.
I can't wait.
Can you?
Can you?
We're on the mountaintop.
We're on the mountaintop.
Here comes Jesus.
Here comes Jesus.
I knew he was alive.
I knew he was alive.
Did you?
Did you?
We're gonna worship.
We're gonna worship.
Jesus our King.
Jesus our King.
I don't think he'll leave.
I don't think he'll leave.
Do you?
Do you?
Jesus said to wait.
Jesus said to wait.
For the Holy Spirit.
For the Holy Spirit.
I wonder what that means.
I wonder what that means.
Do you?
Do you?
Jesus said to go and tell.
Jesus said to go and tell.
Everyone about him.
Everyone about him.
I can do that.
I can do that.
Can you?
Can you?
Look, he's going up.
Look, he's going up.
Up to the cloud.
Up to the clouds.
Let's keep looking.
Let's keep looking.
To figure out why.
To figure out why.
Here come two angels.
Here come two angels.
I think they want to talk to us.
I think they want to talk to us.
I'm not afraid.
I'm not afraid.
Are you?
Are you?
They said he'd gone to heaven.
They said he'd gone to heaven.
When God's ready, he'll come back. When God's ready, he'll come back.
When God's ready, he'll come back.
I believe it's true.
I believe it's true.
Do you?
Do you?
Going down the mountaintop.
Going down the mountaintop.
Heading for Jerusalem.
Heading for Jerusalem.
Gonna wait for the Holy Spirit.
Gonna wait for the Holy Spirit.
Are you?
Are you?
Awesome! You guys did so great. Thank you so much for helping me. All right, so we've just learned that Jesus went up on the mountaintop. He gave the disciples a special job to do, and that was to spread Jesus' love all over, right? So we have a responsibility to go and make disciples of all the nations. Do you guys remember what verse that comes from in the Bible?
No.
No. Guess what? That's our remember verse for this week, and it comes from Matthew 28, verse 19.
Okay? Matthew 28.
Yeah, don't worry. You're going to learn it and all the actions too. All right. So what's really cool about this too is Jesus said that he would send a very special gift to help us do that. But you're going to learn more about that next week, okay? Right now, you guys get to go do your family activity, and that includes, it's called Balloon Messages, okay?
Balloon.
And you can find that on the website. It's just a link that you guys can do. And there's these little cards. It says, Dear blank, Jesus loves me. Every day he blank. Jesus loves and cares for you too. Your friend blank. Your job is to fill this out and tell somebody about Jesus with a little present.
Why are you? Because it's flying up to the sky.
So I got these helium balloons, right? So you can do that. But I also got these pinwheels that you can do. Or you can just write a little note to somebody and give that to somebody. So that's your family activity for this week. Make sure that you send pictures to me. I really want to see your pictures of all the fun things that you do. That's Covenant Kids. Okay, so send me pictures. Right now, we are going to sing one more song. You guys know the song already. We've been singing it for the last couple weeks, and it's called Go. Okay, so we'll see you next week. Thank you to Tyler and Kyle and Julia for helping me out this week. See you next week. Bye.